it is well to reflect that the wilderness furnishes perhaps the best opportunity for pure aesthetic enjoyment. This requires that beauty be observed as a unity, and that for the brief duration of any pure aesthetic experience, the cognition of the observed object must completely fill the spectator's cosmos. There can be no extraneous thoughts, no question about the creator of the phenomenon, its structure, what it resembles, or what vanity in the beholder it gratifies. The purely aesthetic observer has, for the moment, forgotten his own soul. He has only one sensation left, and that is exquisiteness. In the wilderness, with its entire freedom from the manifestations of human will, that perfect objectivity, which is essential for pure aesthetic rapture, can probably be achieved more readily than among any other forms of beauty.